expected difference. Comparing subpopulations differing in X by 1 unit and having, I'm going to actually add another word in here on this, having the same latent random effect.
Sorry, I'm really dumb. So beta zero star, why do you need to have similar bi if, or bi one, b one I, if we've already set x equals zero?
So I condition through the population and x is equal to zero, but I'm saying that among the individual, I condition upon anything else that bi is equal to zero. So it really would go away, but I want you guys to kind of see that that model really has a bi sitting back there.
Okay.
X equaling zero kind of forces that thing out of the picture, but really the BI is floating around.
Okay.
So, and here I wanted to make this kind of a little bit more explicit, right? Same with latent BIs. We call these things latent, right? I've used this terminology with you guys in the past, but it's latent because we don't actually estimate each of the individual BIs in the model. There are these things that kind of define the I cluster, but we don't estimate that specific parameter in the model, right? What do we estimate? We estimate the covariance matrix of those random effects, right? We don't actually estimate the individual BIs. We do that kind of post hoc via what? The empirical Bayes estimates, right? We use the variance covariance and the fact that we assume normality of those things, and then we get a posterior mean to obtain them. But they're not, it's not like we're fitting capital N parameters in the model, right? We're just fitting the variance covariance components that go with those things. So that's why we return them latent, okay? There's nothing measured in the population that we observe that we kind of fix on, right? See that? Yeah.
So that's if we're talking about the conditional mean.
Yes. Okay. Yes. But that's what the way I've got that model written right now. That's exactly what it is, right? I mean, bi is in there, right? And I'm conditioning upon this bi. Okay. So now go back to Hina real fast. Expectation of yi in the conditional model is equal to the expectation respect to little b of the expectation respect to y given little b of yij given bi. That's equal to the expectation little bi b0 star plus b1 star xij plus b0i plus b1i xij. And that thing is equal to interpretation of the conditional parameter is that what is the mathematical relationship between the conditional parameter and the marginal parameter in the linear model? They're exactly the same. So you can't really mess them up. I mean, they do have two technically different meanings, but they are mathematically the same. You are estimating the same quantity there. That's because linearization is split through. Okay? All right. So now, I timeline off, so this is problem three of the midterm. So we'll consider this marginal model. And we'll consider a random intercept model to start off with. First of all, the interpretations of these guys are going to be, we were okay with this, right? So here you're talking about e to the beta 1 would be the relative difference in the mean of y comparing two subpopulations differing in x by 1 unit. Great. Down here, e to the beta 1 star would be the relative difference in the mean of y comparing two subpopulations differing in x by 1 unit by having the same latent random intercept. With me? I'm conditioning upon people that are like one another. And again, if you think about that you've captured everything that makes me me inside of the random effect, then it's like saying the within subject effect, right? I'm conditioned upon everything that makes myself myself. Okay. So now, though, if you want to compare these two models, same thing holds, right? So now, from this conditional model, if I want to talk about the marginal interpretation, the question is, what's going on with these guys? So, same trick, iterative expectation. That's just going to be e to the beta 0 star plus beta 1 star xij, but now I'm going to have an expectation. This is again with respect to e of e to the 0 I. So now, if you do that, I think what you're going to get is this thing is going to have expectation tau squared over 2. That was the hint that I gave you guys inside of the midterm. So this model then will look like beta 0 star plus, I'm going to group things together a little bit like this, beta 1 star xij. So now, as you go to compare the conditional model to the marginal model parameter estimates, what are the same mathematically? What are you consistently saying the same, and what are changing? In the random intercept model. The slope remains unchanged, right? This is still a linear model, and x, beta 1 star, is still that relative difference comparing two subpopulations differing by 1 unit with respect to x1. Okay? Intercept gets shifted, right? And it's going to get shifted by whatever tau is. So they do not have the same interpretation on the intercept. But the slope, the association parameter remains the same. Fantastic. So now, think about